हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू सिविक्स क्लास। वी हैव स्टार्टेड क्लास 10 सिविक्स चैप्टर 2 फेडरलिज्म। इन द लास्ट वीडियो आई सेड दैट वी विल हैव वन इलेबोरेटेड पार्ट 4 वीडियो व्हिच इज व्हाट मेक्स इंडिया अ फेडरल कंट्री। दिस इज पार्ट 2 ऑफ द सेम वीडियो। इफ द क्वेश्चन कम्स दैट व्हाट मेक्स इंडिया अ फेडरल कंट्री, देन आफ्टर एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट थ्री फोल्ड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ पावर we will give or write these points which we will be discussing today, okay? That can be which we have discussed in previous video, that threefold distribution of power among on legislation. We have seen three list: union list, state list and concurrent list. So that can be a separate question also, means explain the threefold distribution of power. And it can be a combined question also, that what makes India a federal country. If that comes there, then you have to write that threefold distribution of power and these points also which we are going to discuss today. Okay, so let us get started. Now another reason why we call India as a federal country is India is holding together federation, unequal power among the states, special powers are given to few states. Okay, so now what does this mean? What are the special powers? As we said that in the holding together federation and in coming together federation, there was one major difference, that in coming together all the states of that federation, they have equal powers. But in holding together, states may not have equal power or states have unequal powers. Okay, so how is this practiced or how it is, you know, formulated? Let us go to history first. Now we have seen that Article 370 had been in the news, right, few months back. So Jammu and Kashmir enjoyed a special status as per Article 370 and also special category status, which was SCS. But now that Article 35A, under which it was given the status of special category status, it has been scrapped and it has become a union territory with legislature. So SCS does not apply now to Jammu and Kashmir. Okay, right now it doesn't exist. But there are more states which have those that special status. Okay, we will be studying about them. Okay, but here why we have taken the example of Jammu and Kashmir, because we are studying that states may have unequal power, right? So now we will see what is the historical background of category special status. First, this concept of special category status was first introduced in 1969 when the 5th Finance Commission sought to provide certain disadvantaged states with preferential treatment in the form of central assistance and tax breaks, establishing social development boards, reservation and local government jobs, education and institutions. So let us make it simple. It is just that in 1969, the Finance Commission came to know that there are few states, okay, we'll be studying about them, which are suffering from underdevelopment, or you can say where infrastructural development is very low. Okay, it can be geographical barriers, there can be why the infrastructure development is very slow or it is not there, or you know that these disadvantaged states, they should be given special treatment. Okay, or they can be given a relaxation in paying taxes. Okay, so they can get assistance from central government. Okay, so there can be reservation for those states, or there can be educational institutions which provide them services at very low cost or free of cost and all. So such services can be given, or such treatments or such relaxations can be given to the states which are under development, or you can say their development process is very slow. Okay, so it was thought in 1969. Then, initially, initially only three states were given the status of special states: Assam, Nagaland and Jammu and Kashmir. They were granted special status, but from 1974 to 79, five more states, they were added under this category. Means how they are added? Once the states are recognized that these states are also, they also need assistance from center, okay, they also need special treatment for development and all. So these states were Himachal Pradesh now, Manipur, Meghalaya, Sikkim and Tripura. Okay, so now they have become eight total by 1979. But now in 1990, with the addition of Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram, the states increased to 10. Okay, then later in 2001, Uttarakhand was also given special category status. Okay, but after the dissolution of the Planning Commission, the formation of NITI Aayog, the recommendation of the 14th Finance Commission was implemented, which meant the discontinuation of Gadgil formula based grants. So now Gadgil means this was the one Gadgil on the name, okay, so the one who initiated this, so on his name it is, that formula is named Gadgil formula, means a formula of giving special status to states. So after the 14th Finance Commission, this scheme has been now stopped. Okay, now no more states will be given special status, okay, according to this. Okay, all this will never be asked in your exam. This was just additional information. I thought you should know that what is the history of giving special status, or why the states are given this, you know, they fall under the category of special status. It is on the basis of infrastructural development, or there can be geographical barriers, okay, whatever can be there, why which is why they may need special assistance for development. Okay, so let us get back. So Jammu and Kashmir had its own constitution, it had special states. Now the part 21 of the constitution consists of articles, temporary, transitional and special provisions of some states other than Jammu and Kashmir. In part, apart from article 370, there are also articles 371, 371A, 371B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J. Okay, like this. Okay, we states which we have already seen. Okay, they were given the special status. Now, union territories do not have the power of state. Central government has special powers in running these areas. As we said that all the states don't have equal power. This we have proved in this point, that few states have got the status of special states. Now, another feature that which makes India a federal country is, There are few regions which cannot be called states, okay, because they are too small to be called a state, okay. Or so these are the union territories: Andaman and Nicobar, Chandigarh, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Daman and Diu, not is separated, Daman and Diu, okay. Then National Capital Territory of Delhi, Jammu and Kashmir, Lakshadweep, Ladakh and Pondicherry. So these states, they don't have the status of a state, they are assisted by the central government. Okay, central government rules here, they don't have state governments. Next is, power sharing is a basic structure of the constitution. These arrangements cannot be changed easily. Okay, as we said that I have been discussing about this in the previous videos also, that this arrangement of power sharing cannot be changed by any level of the government very easily. Okay, power sharing means which government or which level of the government will make laws on which subjects, or what is the revenue collection policies or administration and all. So it cannot be changed. Okay, it is not so also that it cannot be changed. Yes, it can be changed, but what is the criteria? Any change to it has to be passed by both the houses of parliament with at least 2/3 of majority, then it has to be ratified by the legislatures of at least half of the states. First of all, 2/3 majority in parliament should be there. Okay, if any change is initiated, that in power sharing arrangement, any change has to be brought, then it should be passed in the parliament by 2/3 of majority, and at the same time, not only parliament but also by the state governments. Okay, the legislatures in states. If there are 28 legislatures, then out of that 14 legislatures at least, they must also pass with same majority. Okay, it means that none of the level of government unilaterally, they cannot change this arrangement. Okay, so judiciary takes decision in case of any disputes. If there are any disputes or differences of opinion between center and state government, then judiciary will take care of the disputes, because judiciary is the highest interpreter of the constitution. It will explain that this power, or any, if the basis of a dispute, whatever it is, judiciary will explain that which part is right, or where we need to make amendments, or where we need to make what else is to be done. So Jurishi takes all the decisions. It works as umpire, as in the cricket. We have already seen that. Okay, so these were the points to be covered under the topic, what makes India a federal nation, okay, federal country. Let us just have a quick review. First, India is holding together federation where unequal power among the states, okay, where there is unequal powers among the states. So here in this we have discussed that. Okay, you can just, if you want to beautify your answer or impress the examiner, you can quote that, that slide which we discussed here. You can just write this. Examiner will get to know that you have the total idea of special status, what it is or why it was given, when it was initiated. Then you can, then next you will write that union territories don't have power, okay, of states, and central government has a special power in running these areas. Then power sharing is a basic structure of the constitution, and these arrangements cannot be changed easily. And if they want, there is need to be to change, then what is the arrangement? Parliament should have should pass it with 2/3 of majority, and the state legislatures also must pass it, or means at least half of the states. Okay. So with this, now we complete our topic, what makes India a federal country. I hope you have understood. You may have queries, please write to me in the comment section. I would love to solve the queries. See you soon in the next video. Thank you for watching.